Ladies and gentlemen, good evening, and welcome to the launch of the Valletta Art Museum, the VAM. We would like to thank the Malta Arts Fund for their support, Lily Aguis Gallery for hosting this exhibition, and our sponsors. How many of you have recently been to the old covered market? How many of you have walked around here, feeling sorry for this place? What happened here? Why is it empty? Why is the roof leaking? Why are there no stalls anymore? How could we have allowed this to happen? Most of us have never stopped asking these questions, but around a year ago, we decided to try and find some answers. The old covered market was designed by Hector Zemelli and completed in 1859. A pioneering architectural landmark, introducing an innovative building concept to Valletta, and indeed to the island. Putting aside the traditional load-bearing masonry construction, the building structure consisted of a lightweight frame allowing large spans and an open-plan layout. In this drawing, we can see the original extents of the building. One full block extending between St. Paul's Street and Merchants, with no piazza in front, just a street full of activity, culminating with this urban magnet. The first blow to the building was a direct hit from an air raid in 1942. The front of the building was destroyed, together with a large part of the clerestory, which was its main source of natural light. In this picture, apart from the destruction, we can notice how the original market stalls were an integral part of the interiors, a practice, unfortunately, seldom seen today. A makeshift facade was quickly put together after the war. One third of the building has remained missing till this day. The makeshift facade was soon replaced with the reconstructed, arched facade. Built in the same rhythm as the original, the new facade was shifted back from Merchant Street. This is the only picture that was found, which shows the original open plan of the market hall. Void of any accretions and walls, one can notice the natural light pouring in from the high-level clerestory windows. This picture was one of the main inspirations of the proposal. In 1982, the market suffered a second, perhaps more devastating blow. The Suttal Belt was closed down and shifted out to a new building in Floriana. Named Istri Malti, an insular bazaar selling only local produce, this prototype supermarket was not successful and very short-lived, but somehow it anticipated the supermarket culture, which was soon to follow. In 1989, new plans were drawn to reopen the covered market. A series of masonry partitions spread over three floors were built inside the market hall. Unlike the original stalls that we saw before, this new layout totally compromised the open space, building a series of garage-like shops in complete disregard of the lightweight colonial structures around. As a great saint once put it, the road to hell is paved with good intentions. While the idea of moving the market back into the city was righteous, it was somehow too late, as the local shopping culture was changing rapidly. Weekly shopping in Valletta was losing its ritualistic character. Supermarkets started mushrooming all over the island, and slowly most Maltese could afford a car, and the luxury of parking on their doorsteps. Besides all this, the declining and aging population of Valletta didn't help. And soon enough, the shops in the covered market started closing down. While most agree that a busy market of this size needs a sizable population to sustain it, it was suggested to turn this place into a food court. A romantic idea, but nonetheless a very dangerous one, since when the gourmet stalls and the delicatessen will be unsustainable, the commercial and the tacky will take over. Look at what happened to these food courts. Do we want this to happen to our old covered market?
And now for something completely different.
When will art be taken seriously in Malta? When will Maltese artists have a national platform to expose their work? The truth is, contemporary art is very low on the national agenda. The lack of a space for exhibiting modern and contemporary art has left various people to fend for themselves. Efforts to establish a relevant platform for the arts have been short-lived, lacking sustainable funding and a central location. How many Maltese children have the opportunity to experience modern and contemporary art? These Austrian children at the Museum of Modern Art in Vienna are discussing a sculpture from the 60s by Klaus Oldenburg with their teacher. In Vienna, like in many countries, art is not only a hobby, but also an experience, a catalyst for fresh ideas and progressive thought. Did you know that one in three tourists choose an artistic and cultural destination when traveling to Europe? Should we just relegate Valletta to an open-air Baroque museum? Or can it become, once again, a centre for contemporary art and culture? In less than 6 years, Valletta could very well become the European capital of culture. Malta cannot run the risk of missing an opportunity to establish a home for Maltese contemporary art. One site being considered is the old powerhouse on the Valletta waterfront. Even though the building offers plenty of space, a recent study concluded that besides being too big for a national museum, the Valletta waterfront is associated with entertainment and nightlife. It will therefore be quite a challenge to market the area as a cultural and contemporary place to visit. Simply put, the VSET powerhouse is too close to the cruise liner terminal, and the commercial outlets of the waterfront, amongst which an art museum loses cultural setting. Not to mention its address, since technically, this is Floriana. Fact is, Valletta already has a cultural hub, attracting thousands of visitors a month. Starting with St. John's Co-Cathedral, the main cultural magnet in Valletta, the nearby archaeology and fine arts museums, and of course, the Grand Master's Palace, earmarked to reinstate the Knight's Armory when Parliament is relocated. Which brings us back to the old covered market. Situated just behind the palace on the second busiest pedestrian street, this building could very well be the missing ingredient in Valletta's cultural nucleus. So let's have a quick look again at this building's story. Here's the cross-section. Back in 1859, when the building was longer, symmetrical, up to the edge of Merchant Street. Up until that unfortunate moment in 1942, when its front end was bombed, ungracefully repaired, look at how the roof outline was badly stitched, and disgracefully invaded, with load-bearing walls and partitions, in total contrast to the original, lightweight structure. Not to mention proportions. So, we thought, let's clean it up a little. Get rid of those walls and bring back the market hall. Let's mark the original extents of the building. No more walls, please. What about some steps going down? Invite people in. Turn the basement into the new ground floor. And let's widen those side ditches and make them 3-meter streets. Fill them with light and ventilation. Going down the new, lowered streets, the side arches will lead to the new market stalls, while the front ones inside the VAM. Back to the cross section. From the lower ground floor, walk up to the market hall. look up to the restored clerestory windows. The VAM services and administration, such as storage and elevators, will be housed in a lightweight insertion. Sensibly similar to the original roof outline, while sheltering the new stepped piazza in front. A long escalator, reminiscent to many of us of the old market, leading people to the upper galleries while surrounded by the exhibits in the market hall. This, ladies and gentlemen, was the design process of our proposal. The building's cross-section, and indeed its history, encapsulated in a new experience, complemented with progressive functions. And here is how we imagine it will look like. Here's a view of the VAM from Merchant Street. Spaces between the arches are liberated and transformed into exhibition niches, which overlook the street and public piazza. The stepped piazza, leading to the relocated entrance, reinstates the building's original alignment with Merchant Street and turns the basement into ground floor. The current two passages flanking the building are widened into sheltered streets, creating a pedestrianized perimeter of market vendors, cafes, and food outlets. A derelict space used for storage purposes, the present basement will become the entrance hall and lower galleries. The market hall at the VAM. Here depicting a contemporary show of the 17th century Flemish tapestries. This image also shows how it is the narrative and not necessarily the content which creates a contemporary experience. Stripped of all accretions, the VAM Market Hall becomes a flexible exhibition space capable of containing large format installation art and sculpture. A central escalator encourages visitors to climb from the Market Hall to the upper galleries. The upper galleries allow visitors to appreciate both the VAM Market Hall from above as well as the intricate details of the colonial structure. The cantilevered extension above the VAM serves as a dual function, providing alternative exhibition spaces while sheltering the piazza below. It also recalls the original extents of the pre-World War II building. The lightweight and translucent upper galleries hover over the facade, presenting Merchant Street from a new perspective, while sheltering the piazza users below. The VAM shows will extend over closing times, its stepped and sheltered piazza accommodating cultural gatherings, its translucent extension a beacon in Valletta's nightlife,